स्पीकर की जरूरत नहीं, डायरेक्टली सुनाई देगा। गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन, गुड मॉर्निंग एवरीवन। टुडे आई एम हियर टू डिस्कस फ्यू टॉपिक फ्रॉम सी ऑफ कॉम्पिटिटिव साइंस, दैट टॉपिक व्हिच हैज एक्सप्लेन्ड बाय मेनी स्कॉलर्स इन देयर ओन राइटिंग्स, बट आई विल स्टार्ट दिस टॉपिक एंड वी विल एलाबोरेट दिस टॉपिक अकॉर्डिंग टू व्हाट वी आर अंडरस्टैंडिंग व्हिच इज गिवन बाय डॉक्टर सांगर खानानन एंड डॉक्टर प्रफुल्ल विजयकर सर। Before we start, let's we express our gratitude towards our masters, though which is beyond word, still we'll attempt. Our tribute to our master Dr. Samuel Hahnemann, a person who is always in state of humanity and he never appropriated anything for himself. So even if an allopathic physician, even if learning whole allopathy and with the right thinking, sensorious critical nature, he has understand what is going on is not correct, we find out the right way of homeopathy. Salute this person who has developed this wonderful science for all of us, and we have to take this in the next level. Our next tribute to our master, revered Dr. Prafull Vijaykar sir, for everything, a person who is son of homeopathy and led in a knowledge of homeopathy for a whole humanity. He has a dynamic influence on all homeopathic students, homeopathic faculty, and he has made so many homeopaths all over the world who is practicing a better and better homeopathy day by day. My again next tribute to Dr. Thanks to Dr. Prafull Amrish Vijaykar sir, who has allowed me and given me this opportunity to this wonderful journey, taking the search mission on the next level and spreading the right knowledge of homeopathy all over. That's why this series is called as Sadhana. Now the two topic we are taking today, one is self defense and second topic we are going through is the body defense vis-a-vis mayatan. Now let's move towards the topic. Before we start the topic, there's a great line written by Dr. Boninger Sen: the greatest comfort on the earth to man in incurable cases is homeopathy. Whenever he is practicing the homeopathy, Dr. Boninger Sen, who is next to Dr. Hahnemann, and he has written this: in incurable cases where everything is failed, when there is no hope and patient is not responding, disease is not taking care, on that time with the homeopathic knowledge, homeopathic understanding and the right way of thinking, we can give a medicine and the patient will completely better. So this sentence is very much important. A student of homeopathy or the first practicing homeopathy, if they understand this, see how great the science is, and we have to study according to that, so we can take this in a better way. Let's start the topic self defense, and second is material body defense vis-a-vis. Now we have to understand the pathology. To understand the pathology, that is the disease, one needs to first understand the physiology. Okay, now why to learn the physiology? This is very important thing, because when we are practicing, when we are a student, that we understand that we don't know the cell mechanism, we don't have that much knowledge of cell, we just have to ask whether patient is better or not better, thermal thrust, and why you have to go so deep in medicine to understand that all level. But as we grow, as we contact in the sir, we understand the importance of this, ki why we have to study in so much deep level to accuracy, come to the near the accuracy and prescribe the right remedy. That's why a physiology is very important. In physiology, when you are in, what is physiology basically? A physiology is the processes. There are more than 15 trillion cells in the bodies, and there are colonies of cells which functioning together, and for that functioning the processes is required. This process is called as the physiological process. Like I am talking today, that is a process. I am breathing, respiration is process. My GI is working now. That is the process. So this all process is physiological process. Now, if everything is going fine, my physiology is fine, I'm working fine, I'm doing everything well, then what has happened where the defense is required? Okay, now everything is smoothly going on. No problem, nothing has happened. Then what has happened? So that cell has to be defense. Okay, this is a very important thing you have to understand first. As a cue, why this has come? Sub normal hai, sub theek hai, suddenly I got fever in the morning. Why? Sub theek hai, I start the loose motion in the afternoon. So this, even if everything is functioning, so where these things just go wrong and give rise to the complaints. Now before it directly goes to the complaint or the disease, before that there is the processes. So first we understand the processes, we understand very well how it is going. In modern medicine, it is called as homeostasis. What is homeostasis? The term homeostasis is used by physiologists to mean maintenance of nearly constant condition in the internal environment. Essentially, all organs and tissues of the body perform function that helps to maintain this relative constant condition. Now here we have to understand, a modern medicine is always mentioned, it is maintenance of nearly constant condition. What is nearly constant condition? So it is not fixed. A normal homeostasis for me is always different from normal homeostasis for other. Like a soft talking is me for the normal, but the person can talk loudly. That is normal for him. So it is different. That's why it's related nearly a constant condition. Of all organs and tissue, a body performs a function that helps to maintain this relative constant condition. Again, I have mentioned the relative. So it is not fixed. It is not all like one. आपके लिए ये सही है तो दूसरे के लिए भी वही सही होगा. Maybe the desirable difference by homeopathy, maybe the understanding. In modern medicine, the dosage will also shifted to the person to person. Some will react to 300 mg dose, some will react to 400 mg dose. Some the fever will settle down within 2 ml of syrup, some will require 5 ml. So it is difference. That's why that is called as, Hahnemann has mentioned, individuality. So every person is different, every person understanding is different. This same homeostasis, Master Hahnemann has mentioned in aphorism number 9, what is health? He has explained a wonderfully, in a healthy condition of the mind, the spiritual vital force that dynamates, that animates material body. Now this, the spiritual vital force is not come in the modern medicine. They have not mentioned it. They have only mentioned that animates material body, rules with unbounded sway and retains all part of the organism in admirable harmonious vital operation. Admirable means that is relative condition. But modern medicine has mentioned the relative term, it is admirable harmonious vital operation. As regards both sensation and function, so that indwelling rhythm gifted mind can freely employ this living healthy instrument for the higher purpose of existence. Now, this is also not the part of the modern medicine. This is the extraordinary which is written by Master Hahnemann and for us. Okay? For we have to differentiate why this is two are different thing. Okay. Now, if everything is going smoothly, my physiology is going normal. So when we born, any cell, any living tissues, or living person, animals, or living animals, plants, okay, all have cells. Cell is the smallest structural, functional, and biological unit of that living organism. This cells is different from everyone. Every body, like animals has different cells, plants has the cells different, the functioning also different, and the human has the difference. That cells contain same thing, nucleus, riboplasm, cytoplasm, DNA, RNA. Okay, but this is there. So defense, your defense start when you born. Once you born, you have start your defenses. And that defense, why you have to defense? Why you have to go to the this defense, different mechanisms. Okay, so let's understand this, why the body has go into the processes, like something is going very normally and suddenly that has got changed. So there are few conditions because of that we are getting affected. Now what is that condition for that we are getting affected? The first is diet, second is change in the weather, third is the mental, and fourth is the third is the exertion. That can be come under the mental and the physical, not diet. We come to the topic diet. Diet is requirement for nourishment, basic our regular activity. So we eat according to that. Every person is eating differently, different the desires and aversion according to that. But when we sometimes you eat more, if you like something and if you eat more and body don't want that, body don't keep themselves. Okay, it has to be thrown out from the body. Like you will have a loose motions, you will have a vomiting, or you will have fullness or uneasiness. That uneasiness feeling tells that there is something abnormal and body is crying for something. That crying, that uneasiness we have to understand. This is body's self mechanism to react. So everything, every time, even if a normal day-to-day activity, if something is coming to you, you just go outside. So that will not, you should not hit by them. So this is your reaction. So physiological process has their own reaction. When you have that change in the weather, there is some sensitive people when weather has got changed, very cold, very summer, they will not tolerate. They will have unko chakkar aa jayega ya wo niche gir jayega. Okay, at the same time they have migraine, they have headache. In winter they have recurrent cold and cough. So these are the different things. For everyone is different. A third thing which is very important, exertion, a vigorous exertion. If I do very heavy exercise today, my whole muscle gets fatigue. That means if I got any injury or blow to my, it gives the swellings. Okay, and the mental, which is very important and not considered by the modern science, but this is considered by only in the homeopathy. What is mental? Some sad events happen with you, fright, grief, sorrow, constant vexation. That has give rise to the company. Now all these have, we have a normal reaction. We try to manage on by our own. Okay. Once you try to manage, that means you can be normal within 24 to 48 hours. This is just some scope to you. You get normal after some time. But if you're not normal, that means problem. This process is basically called as the adaptability. Sir has mentioned those who are adaptable, those who got change according to the system and time, they will survive. If you are not able to change according to time, you will not survive. And the biggest example of this on earth is dinosaur. Even if it is very big, they can't adapt themselves, so they can't survive. Okay, so this is basically the adaptability. Now what is the adaptability? The quality of being able to adjust to new conditions or capacity to modify for new use or purpose. This is the basic definition of adaptability. But if you understand what is adaptability in very precious manner, homeostatic equilibrium in changed circumstances by bringing about change in themselves is called as adaptability. Homeostatic is basically our normal things, that is healthy condition. So homeostatic equilibrium is changed circumstances. When the circumstances around you got changed, okay, bringing about change in themselves. I change myself during that circumstances, I will get normal. If there is a bahar koi jhagda ho raha, I will go to the another. I don't want to hear that, so I avoid this. This is my adaptability. Till that adaptability, I get normal. The same way there is a processes and there is a defense mechanism. So the cell has its own defense. That defense you have to understand now. Physiological defense and morphological defense. What adaptability has already mentioned by Dr. Hanneman in aphorism number 150. What is adaptability? If a patient complains of one or more travel symptoms that have been only observed a short time previously, the physician should not regard this as a fully developed disease that requires a serious medical aid. A slight alteration in the diet and regimen will usually suffice to dispel such an indisposition. Okay, now this has mentioned when adaptability may, you have to change little bit of yourself and you will be all right. So you don't have to prescribe on that thing. Oh my God, the patient is having this complaint. He has a loose motion or so. That's why the history taking is very important. Doctor, in the morning I have eaten this. Yesterday night I have eaten this, and I have having a diarrhea since morning 4 to 5. Advise him take the soft diet. Wait till the evening. Until evening he is already all right. A person goes into the rainy season. They came home. They have a fever. Wait for till evening. If the fever will not come again, that's when body has taken it. Okay, so all this has explained by Dr. Hanneman also how to take care of this. Now we have to understand a cell. We have already discussed what is the cell. Cell is defined as the smallest biological, structural, and functional unit of the living organism. Now, defense mechanism. That is, first defense we have to learn the physiological defense, and second we have to learn the morphological defense. First we go for the physiological defense. What is physiological defense? When body has given rise to, when the cell has injury, they have go into the process. Now defense you have to understand by the cellular level. How the cell is acting, how the cell is going through the processes. Okay, so this will give rise to the defense. The first we have to understand the sign of inflammation. So any defense, the Dr. Hanneman also mentioned about this, and Dr. Vijaykar sir also told this, in the defense mechanism, the primary process has to be inflammation. Okay, once there is a no inflammation, that means there is something is wrong. If you have got injured something, you have to get a redness, you have got all signs of the, or few signs of the inflammation, so that's your body is reacting to them. If it is not reacting, that means there is something is normal, then we have to take care of this. This is the physiological level. Now, how is the cellular level we have to understand? What is the basic cell? Cell has one nucleus. In nucleus, there is DNA, RNA, ribosome, and cytoplasm. This is the basic cell structure. Okay? When in inflammation, see, you understand this is basically cell structure, and every cell has its own character. Let's understand the process of inflammation, which has already explained in pathology also and in physiology also. Okay, and Dr. Vijaykar sir also explained in his books how inflammation has to take care. So any inflammation will give rise to the five signs: rubella, tela, dolla, tumor, and functional. Okay, this signs of inflammation shows that your body is still fighting. Your body is trying to overcome with the situation. That means there is an inflammation. That is a equal response to the external stimuli. That means you are inflamed. If anyone slap you, you have to give against. If anyone tells you, you have to give back on that time. That means your reaction is normal. So inflammation is always a process where body tries to overcome from external influences. That is called as the inflammation. Okay, Ruba. Rubella is redness, tela is heat, dolla is pain, tumor is swelling, and functional laser is loss of function. We will take an example to understand this. If I got any injury, okay, the first sign is redness, then that part is got warm, then there is a pain, there is a swelling, and you cannot move that part. So the function has got affected. How this happens? Why this has got happens? And how this works inside the body? Okay, anything which has got affected, any injuries, any cell in the body is responding in all these mechanisms only. If it is not responding, it's either some person have more rubella, less dolla, more tumor. It different according to person to person. But all this sign has to be patient. What is rubella? Is redness. Redness is what? So anywhere, if you find out the foreign body inside the body, tries to overcome. How it will overcome? It will send the more cells, more granular cell toward that side. That will give the redness of that. Once they have give, it is give heat. A thermostatic mechanism has changed. By increasing the temperature, they want to kill that bacteria. That's why over there heat is there. Then swelling. Why the swelling is there? Compared to the other area, over there we required the more effort, more place. That's why you will get swelling over there. And because of the swelling, there is formation of the water, formation of the pus, and exudates. Okay, that's why they will clean from your body. That's why there is a tumor. Pain, pain is the sign, because we will get tenderness and we understand, oh my God, there is something is problem. And if you, should not move that, you have to support our system for this inflammation. If you support the system of inflammation, you will be better within. Like I have got injury and I am continuously moving my hand. So I am not giving rest to that hand. If I am not giving to rest to that hand, it will not be. I have to give rest for some time and I am better. Like if I have, a loose motion and still I am eating something outside food, I am eating non-veg, which is again troublesome to my stomach, then I will not better. My loose motion will be more on increasing pattern. So this sign will tell us there is an inflammation, body is fighting, we just have to take care, we just have to give observation. This is the picture where we can understand inflammation. This is taken from pathology book, where it has mentioned the heat, the redness, the swelling, the pain, and loss of functions. Now, defense. Same as in the body, there is a two types of immune system. How will you defense? Will you defend? We all are defended by our inherent character of property, that is immunity. There are two types of immunity mentioned, that is innate immunity and one is adaptive immunity. Innate immunity, you born with this. Adaptive immunity, you will develop after some time. The innate immunity is basically by the myeloid cell, and adaptive immunity, which is basically by the lymphoid cell. You have to understand it. Innate immunity will have RBC, platelet, neutrophil, eosinophil, basophil, monocyte. And adaptive immunity will be the lymphocytes. That is T lymphocyte and B lymphocyte. Now, being a homeopath, why I have to go so much deep to understand what is going on in the cell? Okay, what happened to the patient? Cold, cough, fever, okay, morning, evening, aggravation, ammunition, and finish. I have to go to so deep level on the cellular level to understand. I will tell you in the later part. Okay. So, sir has already mentioned in the physiological defense, that is the primary inflammatory defense of the body, where body has to be taken care by themselves with this all signs. Okay. This is physiology. Here, a structure will not get affected. My intestine will not change. It will. They will not have the swelling, or they will not the lymphoid tissue swell. Okay, this is the normal where the only processes is either exaggerated or less. That is physiological response. In morphological response, we have to understand two things. Once your body has not responded to the physiological response by any means, like it may be a external forces, it may be your mental stress, it may be your present condition, or XYZ, where your physiological process is unable to take care or unable to overcome. From one point, body has changed the gear and it is give rise to the constructive morphological change, which I already explained by sir, that morphological either construction or destruction. Now we have to understand why the body has changed the gear. Okay, why body is not continuing in the same inflammation process? Right, already I have a loose motion now, because every process has a time and the time of reaction. Once you will not react in that particular time, you have to shift, and that shifting either constructive or destructive. So this mechanism you have to understand, and destructive mechanism you have to understand. This is a simple example. Like if something irritating to us, like to go through it and you have to again touch your part on that part, your skin gets hardened on that part. Okay, you have to understand. Like if you see Mohammedans, they have namaz padte. Namaz padne ke time, they have put their head down. So you get the skin over here is not thickened. What this is? Thickened skin. This is constructive. Body gives more cell on that time to protect the inside part. That's why this is the construction mechanism. We will have multiple examples of this by the construction, like obesity. What is obesity? Like inflammation, strong obesity. It will protect the inside organ, so the fat cells in the body has got multiplied. But from you understand the homeopathic point of view, from where the obesity is coming? From the insecurity. Once you have the insecurity, to overcome that insecurity, either you want to big look, either you go thin. So the constructive has two types: hyperpsychosis and hypo. Either you have to increase, or either you have to see that no one can see you, so it will not affect you. Okay, it will change the emotional also and the physical level also. The cell also has work in the this form only. Either they increase the water inside of the that so clean up the part, either they shrink so much that bacteria cannot enter inside. Okay. The morphology means structure. In this chain structure is required to bring the defense. So it is either by construction or by destruction. As the example, the normal cell has got some influence. If you have a, it constructs to defense. It protects the wall against it, so it will not get affected. Now, sir has given multiple examples of constructive defense. Like in our body, we have our polyps, warts, cysts, tumors, deposition of pigment, which I have explained, and minerals, atherosclerotic plates. All these got as a defense mechanism. This is the constructive defense. Okay. Now, a destructive defense. What is destructive defense? When the construction also not helping, like then body change the gear to the destruction level. That come under ulcer, ganglion, and necrosis. Like body knows that now it is not working. I have to cut off that part. That cutting point is the destruction level. So every diseases, everything has this, all these three things. One is physiological defense, another is morphological constructive defense, and third is construct morphological destructive defense. Now, this all this result is the shift of gear. This shift of gear is Sir's word. That Sir's always teaching, and teaching in this way only. There is a gear change. Once the gear change, you will learn. I can give you a better example in our daily routine also. Something, if the one family, okay, you consider one cell, one body, and one family. One family, there are 10 people living, you understand that? And one body, there is a 15 trillion cell. Okay, now body is a family for cell, and for the people, the whole people are together, there is a family. Now, all 10 people have different nature and the reaction in the body, in the home. Someone is angry, someone is quiet, someone is extroverted, someone is very peevish to talk, or etc. Some is hardworking, some is lazy. But still they are family, they are living together, and they are adjusting each other. So there is no problem. Like in the body also, all processes are working together and there is no problem. When there is external influences happen in the body, the processes is got disturbed. If anything happens in the family, the environment, the equilibrium, the homeostasis of the house has got disturbed. Once that homeostasis has got disturbed, you will start problem of each of the qualities. Like why this is lazy, why this is problematic. Okay, so this is the same way the body also acting. Now, over here, what happens? Once you don't like, you will close. If you don't like the person, first you avoid that person. In the family, like one person or two person is not, they are not in good contact with each other, first they will not look each other. Okay, that is physiological. Avoid. Either processes, physiological process, they solve by talking, by expressing. After 24-48 hours, they will know. So there is no problem, there is no problem. But this fight is continuously in the higher level, but they will close their doors. Construct. You see you, I'm mine. You will not disturb me, I will not disturb. That is, you make the barrier. This barrier is construction. Okay, you don't want to move there. Now we understand, I will not move with this fellow. So better I will up. Now even if I'm awake, that person is affecting me. Okay, that person, even that barrier is not helping, and that will you will left the things. You will left the home. Or he will left the home. Either you or other he will left the home. That is the disturbance. You come out of the circle. Body has to be at that. A family will say you both will live together, away from each other. So that family can say. That is the destruction. So whenever you have got ulcer, when you have got the gangrene, what you try to save that part first by the inflammation, that is all sign of inflammation. If it is not, it is the swelling, that is the constriction. Then it is not, it is the hypopsychosis, that is blood supply is low, muscle wasting is there. So the less the supply, the less will grow. If that is not working, it gives rise to the gangrenous thing. And body try to cut that part. This is a defense mechanism. Now we have till the last half an hour then understanding this defense mechanism, physiological defense, morphological constructive defense, and morphological destructive defense. What is understanding in our day-to-day practice? Okay, why you have to study so much deep of this physiology, this construction, whether it is hyper or whether it is hypo? Okay. So when you are practicing, the patient will come to you and patient will tell the symptoms. Doctor, these things happened with me, and now I am having this complaint. Whether you want to prescribe to that or you want to go to that, it's very important where to wait and why to wait. If you are clear with your thoughts, you know I have to prescribe, then you will prescribe the remedy and patient will be better. But sometimes over prescription, hyper prescription will change the case, and you will not able to get the results. That's why this defense mechanism you have to understand. Now you will tell, okay, physiology will understand this is the reason. Like some cause is there, that cause has now gone, and patient will be all right within 2 to 3 days. So this is the physiological defense that we don't try to give them. Now why have to study a morphological, what is constructive and destructive difference? Okay, why have to study this? Where is the importance of constructive difference and destructive? Whatever happened, whether it is constructive, whether it is destructive, we have to give the remedy only. Constructive may be आपको दवाई देना है, destructive may be दवाई देना है. देखने वाले तो आपका क्या symptoms है, वही देखने. But if you know the processes of this, you have to understand after prescribing the medicine, where the patient is going. Either we have to reverse the situation. Sir always says, when we give the medicine, the processes which has wrong processes which has start, we have to stop that processes. If that process is not stopped, like a person is saying, he is having a tumor and growth, okay, fibroids. Then you give the medicine to them for the fibroid, and after fibroid, a patient is having profuse bleeding for 24 days. A female who is having only fibroid, now he is having bleeding. Now, you understand, normally a bleeding in fibroid also there is a bleeding. There is a painful bleeding, there is a heavy flow also there. But after the medicine, if patient is having continuous bleeding, what is the change? Whether we are right or wrong, in that situation you have to understand what is going on. If you do this kind of that person, you understand that patient is adenomyosis. Now adenomyosis is a circulatory condition. Okay, so you go wrong. This is very important to understand whether we are on the constructive track or the destructive track. Sometime what happen in haphazardly we change the remedy. Okay, like if the person is having, I will give an example of daily routine of practice only. If the person is having adenomyosis, I will take a different example. Like one patient has come with having CA, cancer patients. Okay, patient of bone tumor has come to us, take the medicine, and after that he is getting big abscess in the leg. Okay, now that abscess is so painful, the patient is unbearable, they want to admit the patient. Now what will it do? You will wait, or you will change the medicine, or you admit the patient. Whether this practical understanding is practical defense mechanism is very important. If the bone tumor has getting better and the abscess formation is there, that means it is a good sign. That means we are changing the level from morphological destructive to the morphological constructive level. So this is a need to understand why you have to learn this. Okay. Our next topic is material body defense vis-à-vis myotherapy. Dr. Vijikar sir is the first fellow who has modern medicine and homeopathy. He collaborate and explain the thing extraordinarily. Before sir, no one is there to tell us pathologically whether it is going right or wrong. But sir is the first fellow who tell us and teach us these things. See how the material body defense and the miasms are equilibrium to each other. How? The way there is a three defense in modern medicine, physiological, morphological, constructive, destructive, even vis-à-vis of miasm, there is psoriasis, psychosis, and syphilis. The psoric processes, psychotic processes, and syphilitic processes. This is mentioned in aphorism number 79 and 80. Dr. Hanuman talks about the chronic miasma, psoriasis, which manifests itself by peculiar cutaneous eruption with intolerable itching. This is the fundamental cause and producer of innumerable form of disease. Hanuman has mentioned that psoriasis is the only cause of all diseases. Okay, that same thing, all journey of the diseases, we start with the inflammation. So what the inflammation, that is the psoriasis. Now, a growth, and third is the disruption. The growth is psychosis, that is condylomata. Here, Dr. Hanuman says hyperpsychosis and hypopsychosis. Our sir also explained this. Either it is growth inside or it is either मैं बहुत बड़ा बन जाऊंगा ताकि तुम छोटे हो जाओ, या तो मैं इतना छोटा हो जाऊंगा कि मैं तुम लोगों को दिखूंगा ही नहीं. दिस इज द टू डिफरेंट थिंग इन साइकोसिस. एंड थर्ड इज अ वेनेराइड डिसीज एंड शैंकर एंड डिस्ट्रक्शन वेर अ कंप्लीट सेल डेथ. अगेन वी कंटिन्यू दिस अहेड. सोरा इज द फर्स्ट रिएक्शन ऑफ द स्टिमुलस. The first reaction is physiological reaction to the stimulus is inflammation. Psoriasis is the fundamental cause. Physiological defense is the first reaction to the same thing. All the diseases of psychosis and syphilis are based on psoriasis. All other defense, constructive or destructive, are secondary to physiological defense. Psoriasis is the mother of all myasma. Irritation and inflammation are the beginning of all cell diseases. Acute diseases burst out of latent psoriasis can end in recovery or death, and primary response can be reversible, cell injury, but if violent can lead to the death. Now this acute inflammation or acute diseases, Master Hanuman mentioned in aphorism number 73 also, a rapid onset, okay, can rapid onset and sudden change in the constitution either turn into recovery or cause death. Same way, the inflammations also, that inflammation is due rise to the inflammatory response. It is either reversible or irreversible. Reversible is cure, irreversible is not cure. Okay. Now, you have to understand this in the current scenario, what is going on. In whole society, what is going on? How do you learn this cell defense? Now we have today understand what is the cell defense. We understand what is the cell, what is the characters of the cell, how cell is acting, how cell is responding. Now we have to understand how this today, the pandemic that Corona has affected to everyone. Now as a homeopath, how we have to understand this by modern science and by the homeopathic and how it is useful to us. Okay, what we have done in our practice, by day-to-day practice, Dr. Masters, sir has explained us, and sir's guidance and understanding of homeopathy, we know understanding this in a better way. See, what is things? Now, If you ask whether corona is which man? Sorry, psychosis or syphilis? Which man? The corona basically is a trivalent. Okay, now you have to understand viruses, bacteria, they have came before us. We are coming late. Okay, by the process of evolution, we are late, they are the first. Okay, so if we got some virus infection, this has explained in a full number of certain periods of telluric cause. And sporadic and epidemic, Dr. Hanuman has already mentioned, and Vijay sir already told us why the corona has got infected. Okay, there is the gravitational around is, the changes in that, this new respiratory symptom, and many person are getting affected at the same time in the different area. And it is the fastest way. It's not the shortest way. It is the fastest way. It is either recovery or turning into the death cell. Now, how are you to understand this on the cellular level? Whether your patient is in better, in the physiological different, morphological different, constructive or the destructive way. So let's have a brief idea about this, okay, how you learn this. Now understand, nowadays the patients are coming with us, Doctor, I am having headache, I am having fever. Okay, you don't give anything to them, wait, observe 24 hours, and after that they are better. What it is? It's a physiological reason. You do test, everything will come normal. Slightly raised in the neutrophils, you will see in the report, but nothing else. That means it is a physiological difference. And the corona viruses or pathology is soric, psychotic, and syphilitic. A soric pathology in the reports, we will get to understand what is the change, neutrophilic change. WBC change, platelet count change. Okay. Now, if you understand this as a pathology, how it acts? Coronavirus basically active on macrophages, alveolar cell, and dendritic cell. Okay. On this level, they have primary action and most action on the respiratory organs. So, when he got infected, any person who got infected or affected, by any external cause, mental or physical. Okay? That we cannot discuss now. But any cause if the person is get affected and person infected and having continuous fever. What is the symptom? Basically cough, cold, fever. Nowadays in the second wave there is a loose motions also, severe headache also, and the symptoms and the patterns are now changing. Okay, this is very common in all pandemic. A second wave is always different from the first wave, and the third wave is always different from the second wave. Okay. We are not going to go deep in that part. We are just understanding the cellular level, okay, how it has got changed. When the alveolar macrophages and dendritic cells, all these got affected, body tried to defend to increase the neutrophilic reaction. That neutrophilic reaction increased neutrophil, the total WBC thing, you will have a high WBC level. But gradually it is failed to high, then WBC count will start following and your lymphocytic count has got increased. To engulf the bacteria. Once your lymphocytic count is not increasing, what happened? The degradation product has to be go away. So when this product has come into the bloodstream, blood is got thicker. That's why nowadays a low molecular weight heparin which has introduced to the patient, so the blood should not get thickened and they will not give the clot formation. That is the more waste product in the blood has got increasing. That's why in all patients you will see LDH in the higher side, interleukin 6 in the higher side. What is the interleukin 6? Interleukin 6 is inflammatory membrane. CRP is the result of interleukin 6. Once the interleukin 6 is high, that means your body is still fighting. In a psychotic phase of corona, you will see your lymphopenia will get started. Your lymphocyte will started going down, your CRP started going rising and rising. Your D-dimer has started rising. Why your D-dimer is rising? D-dimer is degradation products. Okay. Because of there is lot of dead cells which increase and bodies cannot be taken care of that, your D-dimer is on the higher side. Once your D-dimer is got increasing, your CRP is got increasing, So that means you end up into the psychotic phase. At the same time, in the lungs, there is a ground glass opacity, and patient will start the breathlessness. What is the ground glass opacity? The alveolar space is taken by a transient fluid, which is exudation again. When the body is cannot fight, they will throw out of the cell. There is one thing intracellular, one is extracellular. Once they will throw out of the cell, it is make a barrier. So your oxygenation will not able to exchange. Once your oxygenation stop exchanging, what you start feeling? Hypoxia. You will start heaviness, you will start breathing difficulty, all this come into the cycle. And that we call as a pneumonia. So we'll go into the second phase, that is psychotic phase of pneumonia. During this time, patient will have continuous fever, or some patient will have no fever. Okay, this is the psychotic affection. When you go into the syphilitic affection, even if that process is not stopped on that level, we will move into the another affection. And that another affection is the syphilitic. What is this? ARDS, acute respiratory distress syndrome. What happens in acute respiratory distress syndrome? The lungs parenchyma totally change and taken by this ground glass opacity appearance. By here and there is a patchy involvement over the lung. That's why the volume of alveoli has got reduced so much, and they goes into that vicious cycle. Once you got into that vicious cycle, there is a hypoxia, aerobic respiration, there is increase in the bicarbonate in the blood. So your pH has shifted, and that's going into the acidosis. Once you got into the cycle, you will in the syphilitic state. That is ARDS. This is syphilitic. So when the while we are discussing this, when the patients are coming to us with the report, with the presentation, we'll understand the patient is in which state. Why these cellular things are very important? Why we will advise them to go and do the reports? Okay, why you tell to go and do at least CBC, at least CRP, at least IL-6 if possible. Okay, or D-dimer to see where your patient is lying at present. Whether he is in the physiological defense, he is in the constructive defense, or he is in the destructive defense. So this is very important to us to understand these all different phenomena. And once, according to Dr. Hanuman has mentioned, it is similia similibus curandi. Once you understand that pathology, once understand patient basic emotions, what is going on, what has happened to the patient and why it is happening. This sir always told two things, kyun hua and kya hua. Once you understand these two things, you collaborate these two things, you give the right remedy, according to the miasms, you will get a good result. Like if you patient is in a psychotic miasm, and if you prescribe him the psoriatic medicine, medicine will not help. Or your thought process of psoriasis, if you connect, if you take the psoriasis symptom and you prescribe in the pneumonia case, you will not get result. Because we are not taking similar things. What is going on in the body? You have to consider that. And for what is going on to the body to understand, we have to understand the cellular level pathology. Where we are going, whether we are going, whether it is in the declining part or the improving part. This is a very important thing where in any diseases, I'm giving the example of corona because of this pandemic, now it is going on everywhere. But you consider all diseases will always land up in all these three phases only. A psoriatic phase, a psychotic phase, and syphilitic phase. A physiological defense mechanism, then it is constructive defense and the destructive defense. So once you understand this small thing, when you understand now every small pattern of the disease changes in the person, then you can able to prescribe in the better way. You can, your totality will have everything what you want. Okay, if I take the symptoms directly, haphazardly what patient is telling, okay, I'm headache in the morning, headache, morning aggravation, okay. Whether that symptom is needed to take or you cannot take that symptom. Whether patient is having the pneumonia and I am taking the headache symptom, which is normal, then there is a pneumonia. If the patient is having inflammation of the lung and I am taking the continuous fever, if the fever is not having any PQRS symptom, Sir has always teaches us the PQRS generals is directing towards the Mayadhar, and the PQRS particular symptoms is always directing towards the remedy. So this is sir's, we are with sir, we are learning from sir. In the clinic, sir has says so many things that is helpful in our day-to-day practice and everything, where we can understand ki how great his understanding and how great his thinking pattern, and where he is thinking very correct. The way he evolved the myasmation has evolved, the understanding of the myasmation has evolved, the correlation of the modern medicine and the correlation of the homeopathy is evolved. So why, even if we understand the another part, why the allopathy is not getting results? You see, nowadays they are not getting results. Why? There is a reason behind of this. First, they are saying hydrochlorothiazide is a drug, use that drug. People are start taking hydrochlorothiazide. Now they say that is not the drug. Now you take multivitamins, vitamin C will help you. Now that is not. Now they start antiviral drug, rabbit. That is not acting. Now they start azithromycin is the only drug of choice. They give azithromycin drug and still it is not working. Now they shifted to the higher antibiotics. They give anti-cancerous drug, toxizumab, that is also not working. Then they again shifted to the another level. This is the remdesivir is the only Ramban upay, and after 1 week back they have told that after 7 days the remdesivir has no action towards it. So you understand, this is if they are right. So understand, where are they right? They are right nowhere. They are still changing. Tomorrow they will tell something different. After some time they will something different. But this is not in homeopathy. What arsenic said by Dr. Hanneman, a same arsenic will work in today also with this sign and symptom. So our system is so strong, so right, so perfect. So if you taken into the right hand and if you practice correctly, conscientiously for the humanity and serving the humanity, you will be never go wrong. And you will always get extraordinary and beautiful results with the homeopathic patient in day to day life, because we have seen, we have got this courage from sir only. The patient has come to sir having a tumor and sir said okay, it will be alright. After 6 months there is a no tumor in the skin. So where this has gone? Why? So this is the processes. We understand all that processes, and in the right way he is given medicine, he knows where to stop, where not to prescribe, and what is prescribed and how much time he has to wait. So this is a learning what we have learned from sir, and now we are passes on the same things with our own experiences. What sir has understand, what sir has taken in the practice, the same thing we are also getting. And sir has always mentioned, if I am getting result, all my students should get that result only. That's mean it is scientific. Only I am getting result, that is not scientific. Only one person is getting result, it is not scientific. So if everyone is getting result with the same medicine, that is scientific. So this is the importance to understand about these lectures. Why the cellular level is very important. Because someone what's happened now, what is the use of reports? CT scan kyun karna hai? You have to go to the CT scan. You have to give medicine only, na? Fever aa raha hai, you have to give the remedy and make the patient better. You have to go to the CT scan. Kyun karna hai? CBC kyun karna hai? CRP kyun karna hai? CRP agar 20 se 100 aa gaya to mera remedy thoda badalne wala hai. No, this is not there. This is where we are homeopaths are lacking to understanding of the cellular pathology and how a body change. See, it is reactions. A cell, what is cell? Change in the cell is a reaction, and that expressed to you only. If I am having inflammation, it is shown on my face. I am not well. I am having uneasiness. It is shown on my face. I am happy. It is shown on my face. If I am happy, my 15 trillion cells also happy only. No? If I am not happy, how my 15 trillion cells are happy? If there is an inflammation in my body is going on, it is always stressed by my face. or my body, or my reaction, or my action, my energies. So all these parameters, all these generals, sir has always mentioned this, but generals are very much important to understand the patient's general health and general condition. So when you understand generals, at the same time if you understand the pathology, when you understand the cellular level, and if you have a knowledge of the medicine and knowledge of the homeopathy and knowledge of the miasm, what Hanuman has mentioned and what sir has elaborated very correctly and wisely, your medicine will not go. By any means you are not good. It has to be well. And that's why this miracle has happened. Patient on ventilator, you give the medicine and patient will better. Why it is better? Because of this only. But we have, sir always says, our success has to be increased day by day. If I am treating now 10 patients, I have to see 100 patients with the same results. Once I am doing this, if my thousands colleagues are doing this, automatically 1 million people will now understand what is homeopathy. So this is the homeopathy. This is what Hanuman has mentioned about solar psychotic psychedelics, and this is the way Dr. Vijaykar sir has correlated all cellular pathology with the soric miasm. Okay. References from where I have learned all these things. Dr. Vijaykar sir's books, Imagination, Bokar sir's lectures, Physiology Guidance, 6th edition. Thank you.